वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एक्चुअली डेटा वेयरहाउसिंग फंडामेंटल्स. अंडर दिस फंडामेंटल्स ऑल्सो वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट वॉट इज दिस ऑपरेशनल सिस्टम एंड वॉट इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ दिस ऑपरेशनल सिस्टम एंड वॉट इज दिस डिफरेंस बिटवीन ओ एल टी पी एंड डेटा वेयरहाउसर्स कॉल्ड ओ एल ए पी. दोज बेसिक्स वी कवर्ड इन लास्ट सेशन. And in today's session, we are going to discuss some more advanced information about particular data warehouse. Then we'll go for after completion of the basics, we'll go for this tool as well. Just right. We already covered okay definition of this data warehouse. Also, there are two persons give the definition for data warehouse. There are two fathers we simply call. They give the definition for data warehouse, and we already covered that part also. Only one class is completed with this basic information. Just right. We are in discussion with the difference between OLTP and OLAP. Next, we'll go for the data warehousing implementation approaches. With one more thing is, we'll also discuss the data warehousing architecture. Here, what are the major differences between OLTP and OLAP? What type of differences we can identify in our process? If you see here, first one is the user's wise. Generally, who will access the data whatever we have in OLTP system? This is going to access by the operational team who is doing the operational support in that particular business. For example, the clerical people. Today you went to one bank, you want to open account. Who will help us to open account? The employees are okay, the clerks who are working in a bank, they are going to help us. Means those are the people will access any OLTP systems whatever we have in our business. Next is OLAP, means online analytical processing. What is this online analytical processing data? Means this is going to access by knowledge workers. Generally, the data warehouse data or OLAP means the data is going to be used by knowledge workers, and they will access that okay data with the OLAP system. And next one is the okay, please mute yourself. I'm getting some voice. But functionality wise, what is the use of this particular OLTP systems? As we discussed in last session, let me show you again that particular project architecture, then you can understand this. What is those OLTPs and OLAPs also? Just a second. Let me open that folder. Yep, just a minute. I'm opening the corresponding folders. So when we see any particular project architecture, we can understand what is this OLTP systems and what is this warehouse systems also. There we can easily identify that. Here, when you go for that particular project, okay, generally the OLTP systems data, whatever we have, that will be useful for day-to-day operations. But the data, whatever we have in OLAP, will be useful for decision-making process. That's it. Let me open that. One project architecture I'll show you. Can understand. See, if you see in this particular project architecture, you can get. See, these are nothing but our OLTPs, our front end, our systems. This is warehouse. Now we are discussing about the difference between these systems and these systems. Okay. First difference we discuss, that is about the users wise, who will access the data. Second difference we discuss about the what uses of this system data. Whatever we are taking here, what is the use of that particular system? That's also we discuss. And next one is discussing here is the database design wise. Generally, if you see OLTP system data there. We can go for the OLTP, just let me open that one to explain it clearly. If you have any questions, okay, this is the OLTP. For example, here I have one front end called account open. This account open is a one front end application. This is the application data, right? And CAM workflows is there, CAM system is there, A application processing is there, card system is there, and okay, other systems are there. Each and every system is going to maintain that corresponding application data. For example, I have a card system. This card system is going to maintain cards data. First is AO system, account open data is there. Means each and every individual system is going to maintain application oriented data. But when we load these all the applications data into warehouse, in single warehouse system itself, we have multiple subjects is there, right? That is the reason we are going to call data warehouse data is nothing but a subject oriented data. The point, this system whatever we have is the application oriented database, whatever we have in OLTP, and whatever we have in OLAP is nothing but a subject oriented data. Right? Next one. But difference between data wise, what type of data we have in OLTP and what type of data we have in OLAP. When we go for OLTP, it's going to maintain current and up-to-date detail level data. Okay, it's going to completely maintain current and up-to-date detail level data. Means today morning I open an account in a bank, data is loaded into this AO system, right? Then after 4 hours I have an address by logging into bank website. Then again March is going to update into my AO system. Again after 2 or 3 hours I updated my phone number. Same, it will be update into my OLTP. For example, after 10 updations from morning to evening, okay, we are running one cycle to load this entire front end system into warehouse. Are we going to make this all the 10 transactions data into warehouse? No. What is the transaction is there? As per you did, okay, so many changes as per the business changes, those we are not going to maintain. What is the latest transaction that we are going to maintain into the warehouse? That's what we are going to call as a OLTP is going to maintain current and up-to-date detail data. But when it comes to OLAP, this is going to maintain historical as well as summarized data that is going to provide a multi-dimensional integrity. Okay. That is a basic difference in operational systems and systems. And usage-wise, if you go into the usage-wise, the data whatever have in OLTP, that will be repetitive usage is there. But when we go for OLAP, that we have ad hoc usage. When we are generating any report or when you're creating any kind of the file or output file or any file, we are going to have huge amount of a single record or 10 record or 100 record. We are going to have huge amount of data generally when we are generating the any kind of the reports or anything from the OLAP system. That is simply we can call as a usage wise OLAP will have ad hoc data. And access wise, if you see, okay, what type of access we are going to have means it's going to have the read and write access generally. And okay, we are going to maintain some indexes, and okay, we are also going to some kind of hashing and primary key column also. But when you go for the data warehouse database system, when you want to get any data, we are going to have lot of scans operation we are going to perform. We want to do lot of scanning in the background means when I execute a query or something on database system, on warehouse database system, it is going to do lot of scan and finally going to throw the result to us. And generally records wise, when we see each and every system whatever we have in him, records wise it will be in general okay, less number of records we are going to have, and even size of database also even generally in MBs to GBs. Data in OLAP. These are the some few basic differences between OLAP and OLTP system, whatever we discussed in last class. Now, next topic we are going to discuss, that is data warehousing architecture. Then we'll go for this data warehousing implementation approaches. Right. What is this data warehouse architecture? Okay, what kind of architecture we are going to have in any data warehouse means? There are multiple type of source systems will be there, and okay, ETL layer will be there, data warehouse will be there, then different reports also we are going to generate. Here, this is a basic architecture. Based on this basic architecture, depend on our project, depend on our domain, whatever we are implementing, we are going to draw the different kinds of architectures in our projects. If you see here, this is one particular basic architecture. In this one, there are multiple layers. First one is nothing but a data source layer. What is this data source layer? What kind of data we are going to have in this one? Data source is our client front-end system, which is going to provide a data to our warehouse. This is simply we can call as a data source layer. Data source layer is nothing but our client front-end system, which is going to provide a data to our warehouse. These data sources are maybe homogeneous or maybe heterogeneous also. Okay, if you see in this example, what I'm showing you, some product related data maintaining mainframes, and okay, marketing data we are going to maintain an IMS, and okay, HR data we are going to maintain the application, and finance related data we are maintaining an Oracle, and accounting data we are going to maintain on Sybase, and okay, any other like ERP data we are maintaining and SAP system means different applications data we are maintaining and different systems. That simply we can call as a data source. Okay, these are nothing but different data sources in there. Next one is the ETL layer is there. What is this ETL layer? Here in this ETL layer, we are going to provide different softwares, maybe okay, data stage is rule and other any Informatica or ab initio. There are different kind of tools are available actually. See, these are nothing but the front end systems or data sources. Now these data whatever we have, we are going to extract the data into this system, that is nothing but a ETL software system. That's called, we can call staging area. What is this staging area? Here staging area is nothing but a user-defined database system. Whatever data we are extracting from front-end applications, after doing some basic transformations, we are going to load into staging area, or sometimes without doing any transformations also, we directly pull data from front-end and we are going to put into our staging box. The process of pulling data or the process of retrieving data from either homogeneous sources or heterogeneous sources into staging area is called extraction. That's what we use over word called extract here. What is the meaning of extract means? It's a kind of process to retrieve data from either homogeneous sources or heterogeneous into this particular environment that is called staging area. See, this is in general basic architecture. Same we can compare in our project. Okay, we can see in different project architectures also. Just a minute. This is one project architecture. These are called data sources, and this is called ETL software. This is nothing but a staging area. This is warehouse called MOTS and ODSs, and this is nothing but a reporting layer that is called Cognos software using to generate reports. Got my point? Now, from these sources, we are going to extract data into this particular staging area. Stage. And data stage also we are using because of there are multiple sources there for get data from these multiple sources using multiple softwares. To get data from different databases, we use ODBC connections. And to get data from web-based application, we use some WinSCP. And to get data from mainframe, we are using Connect Direct Gateway servers. And to get data from some AX, we are using that mainframe data also to put into MQ. And we are fetching the data, those two data and XML, all those formats of data into this ETL layer, they're moving into same staging area. Okay, this is in one project. Let me show you another project also, then you can understand how. Sorry. If you have any questions, you can ask. Just I'm opening some other project. Just to show you how it is going to design. Based on just a minute, let me in this document we have architecture open. Let me show you. See, if you observe any particular business architectures also depend on that particular business. Just I'm showing you different I'll show you some details also regarding this project architecture and everything, then you can understand how this business is going to work and what kind of one architecture. Let me copy this into my system. Then we can discuss how. Just 1 second. I think I got some push. Is happening in another class board this time. Let me check it again. Is it same problem? Why it's coming? I'm not sure. Even we increase the next speed also. Just a minute. Or you guys also please try to check in or end also how your network speed. think, okay, it's not working. No problem. Let me open the document itself directly. See, this is, I'll check, okay. This is here, one architecture was in this particular project. In this architecture, when you observe, it will follow nothing but source systems, and these are called landing area, and this is nothing but our staging box. This is finally warehouse system. Okay, means this also an architecture which we design, but this architecture also will follows on the based on the same basic architecture whatever we have. Okay, in basic architecture whatever we have in tool, based on the same we are designing the this kind of architecture for each and every projects. Okay, see, these are the architectures used generally in our tools, but this is the basic one which we generally, okay, use. This basic is a reference one. Based on this reference one, while creating any architecture for any particular, okay. One second. So, just a minute. Is everyone same issue? I think, okay, most of it's still breaking. I'm not getting. Disturbance in the sense, okay, Vijay, you there? Can you please make me as organizer? I'll mute all, otherwise please mute all of people. Hello? Shit. One second. Slides. So I'm closing all applications also, for example. Even the network speed is very high today. One second. To check even that one, okay, this case. Okay, let me rejoin, otherwise, okay, let me make any one of you as a presenter, let me rejoin.
Sorry guys, I joined in a different mission. Now, okay, we'll check it. Is it okay having still same issue or not? Okay, then we'll plan accordingly, okay, in case any issue in this mission also. Daily we can use this mission. This is 8.7 software is there in this mission. Is it okay now, audio? Or still anyone having any issue?
Yeah, it's better, Suresh, now.
Okay, thank you. Yep, I'll have to check. Yep, I'll have to check. Okay, I'll have to check in that mission. We'll continue. Okay, sorry for disturbance in the meantime. 1 second. Let me open the slides to discuss. Just a minute. We can discuss. 1 second, let me copy my materials into this mission. Today only this mission got new one. Okay, one second, just I reconnected. This is also meeting some lot of issues. I'm not sure. Okay, is it a mission restrictions or okay? Today I'll give my missions to all my missions to admin. I'll ask him to check. Right. We are discussing about these data warehouse architecture. Okay, if you see in the basic architecture, whatever we are discussing. Okay, we'll ask. After discussing this architecture, we'll stop, okay? Not wait much time. But okay, I'll rectify these all the problems before tomorrow, surely, 100% without fail. Okay, these data sources, whatever we have here, these data sources are nothing but these one. These sources which are providing with different heterogeneous source systems. Then, from this, we are going to get the data into the this staging area. In between, we have ETL tool to extract the data. Once data is arrived into this particular ETL tool means staging area, then we are going to load the data into warehouse. Okay, here while loading the data into warehouse, we are going to apply some kind of business logics also, then finally loading the data into warehouse. Okay, that is also one thing we are going to do. This process, whatever we are applying operations in staging area, is nothing but a we simply going to call as a transformation. Means the entire process, whatever we are doing, getting the data from sources to ETL tool, and ETL, this means this staging area to load the data into warehouse, this entire process we simply going to call with the name ETL. What is the meaning of ETL here? Here ETL means extraction, transformation and loading. Okay, what is this extraction? Here extraction is a process of retrieving data from either homogeneous sources or heterogeneous sources into staging database. What is the meaning of transformation? Once the data is extracted into our environment by using our ETL tool, that is data stage or Informatica or any other ETL tool, we are going to perform some kind of transformation operations on the data. Those transformation operations, whatever we are performing on the data, is nothing but ETL means transformations. Generally, once we did some basic transformations, where we are going to store our data means staging area. Okay, we are going to perform staging area these operations. Once we get these all the transformation operations, before loading the data into warehouse system, we are going to generate some kind of unique key columns. Those simply we can call as a surrogate key, and we are going to load that will act as a primary key in warehouse, and we are going to load the data into the warehouse. Okay, this is called loading. To do this entire ETL process, we can use different type of ETL tools, that is data stage or Informatica or Ab initio or BODI or MSVA. There are multiple technologies is there to do this entire ETL process. Once we load the data into warehouse system, we can see different kind of reporting. People will come into picture. They are going to generate different report as per our business. Okay, some analyst will come and some managers will access the data, some executives will access the data, some part of data will also up visible to end users also, okay, customers as well. They can also access their own data, their own monthly statement, their own reports, whatever they required, they can also access. This is a kind of basic architecture in data warehouse. Based on this kind of architectures, whatever the architecture I showed you, okay, just before, in our class actually, in that architecture, if you see, that architecture is built based on this kind of, okay, basic architectures, whatever we have in data stage. This is a simple data warehouse architecture. Any questions here? Is it clear voice now?
Yes.
Or still any lagging up? Any questions? Okay, right. Now let me compare this architecture with project architecture. One second. If you have any questions, please ask me. Just a minute. Let me open that project. Okay, tomorrow I'll copy all, okay, those materials and everything into this mission. Then, okay, we need to, we don't need to open any other drives or something. We can, okay, speed up our class without any breaks. I'm not sure why that system is breaking still. So just a minute. Right, I am opening you the same project document what I showed you just now, the architecture. That architecture we can compare with our basic architecture whatever we have in our warehouse. See, this is architecture. Just I'm okay showing you. See, this is called data source, right? Here we have multiple sources. See there, some data reside on Linux, some data reside on AIX system, some data reside on system Z. Here system Z means that is completely mainframe application. Okay, some data reside on system Z and some data reside on some external applications. What are the external applications we have? These external applications are nothing but some SAP is there, some data came from to us with some flat files, means some text file, text format files is there, and some data is also coming from the system I. System I means here we are going to have some kind of the database is there. But to extract the data also, because see in basic architecture we simply wrote that extract. How we are going to extract? Are we going to simply pick up the data? For example, if it is a database, we are going to write a SQL queries and we are going to fetch the data by using those SQL queries. If it is, for example, mainframe, we are going to use some kind of tools which are external tools is available, and we are going to write some kind of the scripting also. In scripting, we are going to write, once we execute the script, that script will connect to the front end. For example, here we are going to write one script. This script will connect to this front end. It will try to fetch those mainframe files from that particular mainframe system to our landing box. Once those mainframe files are received into our landing box, we are going to convert those mainframe format files into our ASCII format, because data stage is always going to support ASCII format data. It's going to convert that ASCII format data which is available in mainframe into ASCII by using these many number of tools. See, here to extract the data from different applications, we have different tools is there, right? The entire process of fetching the data from multiple source systems into our ETL server is called extraction. Here, if you see in this particular architecture, in this particular project architecture, we have one more staging area. Is it our staging area? No, it's a front-end staging area. Means the people who are working in a data source systems, they also have their own staging area. In this architecture, why they showed this one means, because in this particular staging area, we are going to do some kind of CDC process. What is this CDC means? Change data capture. Okay, that's also very important operation. While loading the data into warehouse, we'll also discuss how to do this CDC process also. But this is in this particular application, in this particular project, the CDC process before coming the data into ETL tool itself, they are doing CDC process by using some third party tool. That third party tool is called Attunity. Okay, by using Attunity third party tool, they are doing. That's what they maintain separate staging area here. Once their data came from sources to this staging box, then it will come into ETL server. What is this ETL server? Means in data stage or any other technology also, we have both client and server machines is there. We are going to install our client machine on either Windows machine or any other machine also, but our server components of data stage we are going to install on Unix or Linux. Here this ETL server nothing but our Unix machine wherever we got installation of our data stage Unix components, our data stage server components. Okay, what are the server components we have here? That server components is going to maintain here. Inside this one, the data stage software is installed. Every day, what is going to happen? Every day, we are going to fetch the data from these all the sources into these servers first, and we are going to do some kind of basic validation. For example, I received today some files. My files may have detail records, but there is no header record, there is no footer record. Or in the data also there is no proper delimiter is there, then are we going to process that data in staging area and staging area to warehouse? No, we simply, once we got data from these all the sources into this ETL layer, after doing the validation, then only we will move the data into staging area and warehouse. In case if our data whatever we received, if it is fails validation, we'll send a mail to front end system saying that today we received this data, in this data these many number of records got rejected because of our validation process. Okay, that is also we need to do. How we can do? By writing some Unix scripting. I'll also explain you how to write that Unix scripting as well. Okay, to do the basic validation. once today, for example, see, this project, whatever we discussing, it's into live, for example. Whenever this project is running in live, whatever data we receive today, it processed into warehouse, but after 10 days or after 15 days, our caller saying that, or our end user saying that there is some issue in his account, or there is some issue in his amounts fields of his bank account, something, then what we need to do? Whenever the caller is reporting some issue, we need to check that day's data. Do we have that day's data in active tables or active files? No. Then whatever we are going to do, every day when we receive the data from source systems to this ETL server, this is simply we can call as a landing area. Why we are going to call with the name landing area? Files are landing. We are getting the files from source systems and putting this into ETL server. Then after doing validation, we are moving that into the staging database. This is a database actually. And warehouse also, database. Okay? And these marts also, database. This landing area, we receive all the files. We did basic validation. Once we move the files from this landing area to staging area, again at the same time, it need to take a copy of that particular file into archive folder. In case after 10 days, after 20 days, if you receive some issue, you can copy that file from archive to active files. You can run if you want your job also, or you can check the data as well. But in archive also, we are going to have some limited time. For example, we maintain up to 90 days. Because it's also not so easy to maintain more years of data in archive folders also. Then what we are going to do? After 90 days, the data whatever we have in ETL landing server, that will be moved into some external hard disks or tapes. In case in future, after 3 months, if I receive any issue, I want to check the data. Then I need to request tapes team to process the data again back to our archive folder. We can restore the data. Once we restore the data, we can use the data for our analysis. Okay? That is called landing area. Any questions here? See, this is the architecture which we created based on basic architecture. Because basic architecture will never explain this much clear. This is actually a project architecture. Anyone having any questions?
What is a change data capture tool called?
Yeah, that is Attunity. 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 Attunity is one of the third party tool actually we have here in this project, but not for every project. Okay, it will vary from project to project and business to business. Because this client purchased the tool that is called Attunity. That Attunity Stream tool is there. They install the Attunity Stream with the DB2 database. Once every day we receive the data from all our source systems, we move the data to this Attunity software. There in Attunity, it's going to check. Okay, with the existing data. For example, today is the first data we received into Attunity. It maintains all the data in those tables. Tomorrow when we receive updation data, it is going to compare the tomorrow's data with this today's data. If there is any updations or new records is there, those only we are going to send into staging era. If same records are by default copying from source system, we are not going to process that data from out of Attunity to our landing and landing to warehouse also. That is one third party. But it's not the case for all the projects. Okay, what we are going to do generally in all the projects is, once we receive the data into data stage tool, in data stage tool we are going to check this ADC process. We identify that, is it a duplicate data or something, then we are going to remove the data, we are going to process only updated data and new inserted records only.
So, data stage supports CDC, right?
Right, yep. Data stage supports, okay, CDC process to implement into data stage tool itself. Any other questions? Okay, right, this is about the ETL server, whatever we have. Okay, in this architecture, if you see in below, we have some third party tool, that is a scheduling tool, that is Control M actually. There are different type of third party tools also there, Control M, Autosys, TWS, okay. We have multiple third party tools also there, okay, to do the scheduling. Scheduling in the sense, okay, which job need to be run first, because in data stage, we are going to create some kind of jobs. What are the jobs we created in data stage? Those jobs we need to put in a sequences. Means which job need to be run first. For example, if a customer want to open an account, first he need to fill up an application. Means application data need to be processed. means the corresponding application jobs need to be run first. Once application jobs are finished, then it will go for account opening process. Once account opening process are done, then account activation process is going. Once account activation is done, then transaction process is going to be started. Right? This is the dependency. Based on business dependency, whatever the technology means, whatever the components we developed in data stage, means jobs we developed in data stage, that we need to put in sequence. Those sequences, like for example, for every module, we have multiple sequences. Those sequences we want to put in some scheduling tool to run those at a time. If there is dependency, we are going to put dependency. If there are no dependency, because those are independent modules, then those can run parallelly also. To run those kind of sequences, whatever we design, okay, in parallel, we are going to use some third party tool, that is Control-M. Once this ETL operations are performed, basic transformations or basic validations are done in ETL server, then data will come into staging area. What is this staging database? If you see here, staging database, warehouse database, and MART, all are reside on same database server. Means all are reside on same database server only. Only what is going to happen? Schema names will vary. Got my point? Database will be same, but schemas will be different. Table names also will be different. For example, I have a schema name CPTP002. That is for the CPTP002_DWH. That is for warehouse. CPTP002_STG. That is for staging area. CPTP002_MRT. That's called for MARTs. These three different schemas is there reside on same database with the three different tables. First, we load the data from this source to here. Then, once we did some kind of transformations here, means, are we going to do transformations in database? Means, are we going to write any SQL queries? We are going to, but we are going to write the same SQL queries in data stage tool itself. We are going to use those SQL queries to do some transformations in staging area. Then, we load the data into warehouse. Once data is loaded into warehouse, we can also create some kind of MARTs. Okay, this is a basic architecture. If you see, just a minute. Okay. This is about the basic architecture, whatever we have for that particular project. Okay, based on that architectures, whatever we created, okay, developers are going to start developing their projects. Okay, just let me show you in detail the architecture. Okay, if you know this level, then only it's very easy to understand the tool without knowing business or without knowing architectures or everything. If you go for tool, it's a waste. See, this is the what I'm discussing right now. This is elaboratively what we have in warehouse. These are called sources, but in high level, not in very low level or something, high level. These are nothing but data sources. Then after that we have CDC process. That's what I told you, Identity. ATT-UNIT, okay, Identity CDC process. Then we are moving this into ETL layer, that's called landing area. Here we are doing mapping and departing and formatting. Then we also have in quality stage to do the data quality process for name and address. And then we are going to move the data into staging area. Here we are doing interface file conversions and coding conversions. And now we are loading the data into, this is a warehouse, business intelligence warehouse. While loading the data into business intelligence warehouse, what are the major operations we are doing? Surrogate key process, that's called primary key implementation, and referential integrity and other mapping as per the specs also. Okay, these are the things we are going to do while doing any architecture. This is about a data warehouse architecture. Any questions? Or any confusions? Just a minute.
Suresh, in this architecture, why do we have two ETL, like there are three ETLs, right? So why are we converting from staging DB to again ETL, again?
Right. So here ETL in the sense we are not going to use different softwares or something, same, only one server only. First, what is we are going to do is, from front end, they are going to process their data to their staging database. Now, this data need to be moved into Identity. For that, we are going to develop some data stage jobs. The same server. Okay. That is not okay, different means here three ETL tools means we are not going to use three different ETL tools. Same ETL tool only. on the same server we are going to have for our data state jobs, this is the source, this is the target. Once we did the CDC process, again the same data will back to staging, and one copy, the same data will back move to landing box. Okay, once the data is received into this landing area, we are going to do some kind of ETL operations as per specs. Means that is the same server, it's not different server or something. Same server only we are going to, means same software only we are going to use for three cases. And once these operations are done, then we are going to do ETL operations again here. After doing this code conversions and everything, this is also ETL. Means, see, here ETL means wherever we are using data stage tool, that is called ETL. In this entire process, we are using data stage tool in these parts. Even here, see, ETL, this is for quality stage. Means the tool wherever we are using, that we represent with the name called ETL. We are not using multiple ETL tools here, only one tool, that is data stage only. Just a minute, I got some question. So the scale code here will be sending any material on that. Yep, I'll send, okay, lot of material for SQLs also if you want, okay, SQL and Unix also. I'll send you some materials, okay, don't need to worry about SQL, it's very simple one. Any other questions? Fine, okay, I think it's very late for you guys today. Maybe, sorry for the, okay, these disconnections in the meantime. Tomorrow I will use this laptop, okay, for classes. In case if you need any issue or something, I'll check for other options also. I don't want to waste, okay, your time sitting here, okay, there is a lot of background voice breakings. Is it I don't know, okay, what is happening in that mission. Is it a mission problem or not sure, okay, I'll check with my admin today. If you have any questions or something, please ask me. Okay, tomorrow we will continue, okay, exact timing, we can start at 7:30 and we will finish at 8:30. And after a few days, my previous batch is going to be completed, then we can shift, okay, half an hour, 1 hour before this class also, then we can discuss 1.5 hour or 2 hours for a day, if you are okay. Once you all guys get installations of software and everything, then we can speed up our classes. Then you can also parallelly practice and you can ask some questions.
And Suresh, can you record tomorrow and the after tomorrow sessions?
Yep, I'm going to record every day except today. Today, okay, there's a different link we processed. Okay, tomorrow onwards I'll send, okay, the actual link, okay, every day. Because every batch I'm going to record. That's what, okay, I have a lot of classes backups there. That the problem is, okay, it's not so easy to upload in these tools. That's what, I'm not providing every day class recording. I'll provide you some important class recordings and, okay, in case if you miss, I'll provide you that one. I'll provide you, okay, no, that's not a problem. Any other questions? I think today, okay, we got two new guys. Or any other, okay, existing people also, okay, do you have any questions or something? Once, okay, if you all guys are confirmed, then, okay, we can share some materials and software links and everything. And we can start data stage tool with a live example, live project. Okay, every day while discussing anything also, I'm going to compare with the project. Then it will be good to understand.
Okay, when are you going to install data stage?
That you can check with, okay, Vijay.
Okay, okay.
He's going to, okay, take care of that for you guys.
Can you send his number or email address?
Yeah, okay. Okay, people are going to share you, okay, they are going to send a mail to you, then okay, you can talk with them. Okay, other people who already downloaded, okay, software, okay, please reply to mails, we downloaded something, we are ready, then, okay, I'm going to, because within 2 to 3 classes, okay, we are going to complete the basics. What is my intention is before basics, if all people are having software in their missions, when I'm discussing tool, you will not be able to confuse or, okay, you will not be able to, otherwise what is going to happen is if I complete 10 classes or 15 classes, you don't have software, no use. After 15 classes, if you start practicing also, you will not be able to sync with my class. Who already downloaded, please reply to me, then I ask my admin to start installation. Or if you have any questions, please reply to mails about your hardware and everything, please reply to me, then we can plan it accordingly. There are 3 versions of hardware, so you can install either 8.1, 8.5 or 8.7.
So your mail ID is same as the big classes thing, right?
Right, okay, you can send to, okay, that mail ID, okay, then, okay, they're going to update to me. That's not a problem.
But I don't have any mail ID.
No, the same mail, okay, you can send same mail ID, they're going to update to me. Anyone having any questions about installation or anything? Okay, fine then, okay, we'll meet tomorrow at the same time. I'll plan to at least take, okay, before half an hour, my time 7, it'll also good for me. I can shift previous batch to half an hour before, then okay, we can start 7 to 8.30, 1.5 hour every day, it'll be good, okay. If I have 1.5 hour, then what is going to happen is in case any breaks or something, at least 10-15 minutes loss also, we can discuss an hour for a day. If it is an hour, if I lost any 10 minutes, 15 minutes loss will be problem. It take more hours, more time, more days also.
We don't have Sunday class, right?
Yep, only Sundays is holidays. Okay, Monday to Friday we have classes. Sorry, Monday to Saturday.
Sunday IST, right? Sunday IST.
That's okay. That I need to check it all you guys. What is happening is, for me it's not a problem, but some people are asking, you guys, okay, for you guys, Sunday evening, not suggesting, okay. If that is means Monday morning for me.
Oh.
If you want that, that's okay for me. Otherwise, if you want to take okay off from my Sunday, then I'll take off. My Monday I can start a class.
It depends on the rest of the people. I mean,
right. That's what I'm telling. Okay, depend on all the people. Okay. Sometimes I'm also going to put Sundays also class because I'm not sure because we are also working okay in companies. Sometimes we may have some issues in our offices. Okay, we may have some urgent works. We may need to wake up every okay. Even today also I'm there at up to 3 p.m. Sorry, 3 a.m. my time. I have only 3 hours of sleep. Again, I'll wake up and I start the classes. Okay, there are some issues in my project also right now running on. I'll explain those kind of issues also. Okay, what kind of issues we'll get generally in production while code is into live. How to resolve those kind of complex issues. We got some complex issue today. Still our people are working. After this class again, I need to log into my laptop. Okay, my office laptop. I need to check into that one also. Okay, in case if any breaks, such a breaks, in case for example I am not able to wake up in the morning or due to that, okay, heavy work in my office or something, in case any break is happened, that's what we want to cover, that one in weekend. We don't want to miss our schedule. That's my plan actually. Okay, this batch I know, okay, I don't want to miss schedules. It should be on schedule. In case if anyone is missing, please send me a mail prior to that one. For example, you have any work or something. If more number of people have some issues, then we can stop the class, or if one or two guys are having issues, because I'm recording every day, okay? Because I'm going to record every day, I'll provide the sessions to you.
Okay. Sir, I just wanted to check with others as well. Usually Saturdays are busy. So can we do a class on Sunday instead of Saturday?
Yeah, no problem. That's what I'm
doing.
That will be very good to me also, okay? If you guys are okay Saturday half, it will be Sunday for me. I'm also spend with my family members.
Right. So Saturday we can take off.
Yep. My Sunday morning, that's what, okay, she's telling.
Right.
If all are okay, then you guys can, okay, at the Saturday, then we can start Sunday morning, my Monday morning. That is okay, depends, okay, you guys, okay, if you are okay, then we can plan it and we can do it that one. Any questions about tool or any software or any other common questions also, even if you're already working or you want to about job, how market is there, and about okay certification also. Okay, in previous batch actually just now I got one question from my previous batch after before completion of class. They asked me about certification. Okay, I can provide a dumps for data stage and quality stage. Okay, you can use those dumps to write certification. It's very easy. Okay, don't be thinking that certification is very critical or something like other tools. We have only one paper of exam. Certification code for data stage 8.5 is 8.7. Still, we did not get certification from IBM. We have only till 8.5 only. I can provide you data stage 8.5 certification material and quality stage certification material also. And I'm checking for information later as well. If I got that one, I'll share you before our classes regarding certification wise. Okay. And project wise, I'll discuss as per our course content. If you see. What I mentioned in course kind of everything will be covered. certification wise, okay, no need to worry about. Okay, you can use the, those dumps and those materials, you can prepare. I'll also discuss in classes, okay, some certification questions as well, okay, how they're going to be asked, and even how to derive those one in jobs, how to get those kind of values. Then you'll also get clear understanding after the completion of your class. Okay, you can write so many people, okay, even my previous batch people also, so many are already done, they got okay 100% and okay they completed, some people have completed the certification without fail. If they, if that is useful, then you can also write. I think its cost is $100. Any questions? Okay, fine. If there is no questions, okay, then we can stop today. Okay, we can start tomorrow onwards with our class. Any other questions, please drop me email.
Basically, if I email big classes, that other email is going to get you, right?
Right, right, right.
Thank you.
Yep. Okay, thank you. Thank you, guys. Tomorrow we'll meet, okay?